Hey everyone, welcome back to Bucky's Customs. Hey, in this video I'm going to show you the new AutoZero touch plate from SienciLabs. And I just got one in the mail. Wow, didn't realize that we got a new t-shirt as well. I like that, gSender t-shirt. Thank you very much. Okay, so we're gonna open this up. And, okay. Show you what the labeling says. It will be available on their website and you'll be able to go there and pick it up. So what I'm gonna do in this video is I'm gonna show you how to use it. And the old one is still good. I still have it hooked to my machine. It works really well. It does your X, Y, and Z, as you know, and it also does your X. It'll also just do your Y or your Z. So it's a pretty neat little gadget to zero your bits out. The issue with this is it was limited to straight-sided bits only. You couldn't do tapered or ball-end bits with it. That's where this comes in. So I'm pretty excited about this. Let's get her opened up and get her fired up. Okay. Holy cow. This thing is meaty. I love it. And nice and shiny. On top it has the SienciLabs logo. And you can see how big this thing is. Now I have small hands, but anyway, yeah. You notice that I see right off the bat, I'm like, how can they do this? How can they do a V-bit and give you exact coordinates of a starting point? And it looks like, if you look at the bottom of this, it looks like this is tapered, which makes a whole bunch of sense. So we're gonna get into this. Let's see what else we got in the package. Okay, so it's the cord that comes with it. Let's get rid of this stuff. And let's set this up. So I'm sure we have to change some settings in gSender. Let's see. Yeah, plugs in the same way as two connection points, depending on which way you want to use it. Remember, you know, we can zero off at any corner or the center. This also has a way of doing your just the Z. It's right here on the side. Difference in size. I mean, big difference in size and a big difference in weight. I had issues all the time with this moving, the wire would move it, and a lot of times I had to hold it still, but in this case I'm not so sure I will have to do that. Hey everyone, before we get started with today's project, I want to say thank you to this week's sponsor, SienciLabs, the makers of the Longmill Benchtop CNC, just like the one we use here in our shop. If you're in the market for a CNC machine and you're really not sure what to get, go to their website, cnc.com, and order your Longmill today. You'll be happy you did. Now let's get back to our video. Okay, we are ready to put a bit in. The first bit I'm going to use is a V-bit. This is a half inch V-bit. Now the idea for this touch block is to automatically zero this bit. So I'm going to let this hang down just more than I would normally. And that way I can make sure, because this one's a little bit deeper than the normal block, the standard block. So want to make sure that it's down far enough, and we are going to hook up the magnet. Now The other thing I'm going to do is that I need to show you is how to set gSender up. Now here I've got it open. We'll go up here to the gear. We're going to go over here to touch probe or probe. And you see we've got the standard block selected. So what we want to do is go down to AutoZero. And you can do this option or you don't have to. This is where you need to test your connectivity. And I prefer to do that, and I would highly recommend you do as well. Once that's done, we can close. Now, over here, what we want to do is typically with our other touch block, we would select the bit. And we typically would only be able to do straight-sided bits. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to select, you notice there's two new options. There's an auto option and there's a tip option. Now for any of the bits that you were not able to do with the original touch probe, like the V bits, the ball end, the tapered end, all those bits that you couldn't do in your other touch probe, you can do in this touch probe by using the tip designation. So we're going to select tip, and then we're going to get this thing put in position. I went a little bit too far there. Now what I like to do is I like to hand screw it down just a little. Now you'll notice there's a square in the bottom of this. You want to be, the tip of that needs to be in the square. It doesn't have to be perfectly centered. I am going to move it just a touch towards the back and a little bit in the X. So right now we're ready to go. I've got the magnet installed and we should be able to probe the X, Y, and Z. Now I'm also going to hold on this touch block and we're going to probe. But first we're going to get connectivity. We got it. Now we can start the probe. Now it goes over to that angle and it kind of reads off of that angle that's cut in the bottom of the block, which is kind of cool actually. Took a lot of engineering to do this, and I know Chris and the guys up there have been working on this for a while. They are incredible when it comes to creating things. And there we go. And that put it right back into our start point right there. So that worked perfectly. So now, How about we try a V-bit, okay? Or a ball nose bit. Let's see if I can't make that one work. I'm gonna run up the Z here. Give us some room so we can get this bit out. Take the magnet off. And by the way, these magnets they're using on these are much more powerful. Much more powerful. So you get good connectivity with those. Now, in the past, I always had issues with the block moving, as I said. And the reason for that, I think, was most of the time it was the wire. You know, just this wire that we put on our collar nut just moves everything around. Well, this is a lot heavier, although I will still make sure that I hold on the block. It will stay in place, I believe, a lot better than what the other block did. So let's send this back in, send it down, and pretty close there. I think I'm gonna. There we go. So Now we are going to do the same thing. I want to do X, Y, and Z. And this is unheard of. X, Y, and Z and a ball nose and a V-bit? Come on. You guys got to be really excited to see this. This is crazy cool. So I'm going to screw this down. We're going to hit probe. And we're going to do connectivity. We got it. And we're going to start the probe. I am going to hold on it. Even though it's not going to move it. Oh, the wire did move it. I think we're going to have to do this one again. Tip for you, make sure your wire's out of the way. Yeah, let's run this again. I'm kind of curious to see how it looks pretty close, but I just want to run it again. Feel more comfortable doing that. Okay. All right. So let's do probe, connectivity. Got it. And we're going to hold this block out here like this. I hope you can still see it. Actually, let's try holding it back here. Ready? Go. There we go, folks. That is really, really amazing. That is totally amazing. Now, one other thing I want to mention to you that will improve any touch block's performance, not just this one, but any touch block, is to make sure that when you're doing an X, Y, and Z, is when this comes into play, is whenever you put your stock in, make sure that it's parallel to the Y-axis and parallel to the X-axis. Because if this is off, obviously, oops, can't get that in there now. If it's off, obviously it's not going to give you the right accurate reading. So make sure you do that. All right, so I do want to try one more bit. This is the tapered ball nose. Put that in the mill. Tighten it down. Doesn't need to be torque tight, just needs to be tight enough. Keep it in the mill. And we'll hook the magnet up. This is going to take the same setting, so we won't be changing the setting. The only thing we'll be doing is changing the bit, because it's an irregular sided bit. So set that back in there, we'll screw it down to close, and we're going to hit probe, connect, yes, and this time I'm not going to touch it. I'm just going to let it do its thing. How crazy is that? That is like crazy good. On the money. Here is a flat end mill.
Okay. Touch probe back in. Magnet on. Keep the wire up. And let's raise it up a little bit and bring it back in. I want to get it down a little closer. We're going to do an XY, and this is a straight-sided bit. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to change from the tip to the auto. And you do that down here where it says tool, change it to auto. Now hit probe. Let's do connectivity. We got it. And we're going to start the probe, and I am going to hold on it. Start the probe. There it is. Another success. I'm really liking this. Let's leave this bit in and let's just do, I'll show you how we can just do the Z. So now what we want to do is we want to flip this over, and you'll see there's a flat spot in the corner. And we're going to put that out here. And now we're going to bring the bit over, and I don't think I'm gonna jockey. I'll just move the touch plate. We'll just crank it down a little bit because we're gonna have to do connectivity. Let's change it to Z and let's do a probe. Connectivity and start the probe. Now it's only gonna go up and down, do the Z, and there we go. Done. All I could say is that I get a new shirt and I got to try it on, and I had to try this one on. I really like it. Thank you so much. Well, we use gSender with the new AutoZero Touch Probe, and I'm amazed at how good this thing really is. And you know, I'm not just saying that because I own a Longmill and I do Longmill videos. I'm saying it because I really mean it. This is something that is really going to be a big plus to me here in the shop. It's gonna take a lot of the guesswork out. Just quickly put a touch probe on, put your bit in, do what you got to do, and a couple of clicks here and there, you're done, and you can move on. It's just so beneficial to have every bit in my drawer be able to use this. And I'm really excited about that. If you would like to get one of these touch probes, go to their website, cnc.com. I'll leave a link in the description below. Just go there and check this thing out. You'd be really happy you did. Well, I got a new toy in the shop and I had to share it with you. I hope you enjoyed what you just saw. I know I'm gonna enjoy using this AutoZero Touch Probe for projects in the future. I'm pretty sure it's gonna be a pleasant addition to what I already have here in Longmill Corner. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel, I would appreciate, just go click that subscribe button. It's free, it doesn't cost you anything, and it really helps us put content out. Click the like button and go ahead and share it with a friend. I really appreciate that. So until next time, thank you everyone for watching. Be safe out there.